is a raid on a moonshine still operating in the southern part of the United States. Among the duties of the investigators of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division of the Internal Revenue Service is the ferreting out and the destruction of this type of lawless operation. Stamping out such illegal activity is difficult and dangerous work. The dedicated officers of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division suffer more casualties in their ranks than does any other enforcement branch of the federal government. This is the story of the many and varied activities of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division. From the moment that man first discovered that the fermented juice from fruits had a kick unequaled by other forms of refreshment, much time and effort has been spent in the production of such spirits. Throughout history, these fermented and eventually distilled spirits have played an important role in many areas of man's life. Serving man's pleasure, they have also served another role as a consistent basis of revenue production. While taxes have come and gone on other commodities or services, taxes on alcohol and tobacco have been a primary source of this nation's operational funds. The early colonists were not strangers to the brew or alcoholic spirits. They brought with them from Europe the knowledge of brewing and distilling. As the nation grew, as settlers moved westward, they found a use for their excess grains in the production of spirits. The brews and spirits often represented the pioneer's cash crop, the medium by which he bartered for the goods and necessities he could not grow or manufacture himself. In those early days, alcohol and tobacco taxes were the main source of revenue to support the colonial government. Beginning with the tiny wellspring of brewing and distilling, these industries have grown into vast complexes of modern industry. By 1866, the brewing industry alone had accounted for over $15 million in federal taxes. From its crude and modest beginnings, the brewing of beer now is accomplished in 15,000-gallon kettles like this. Today, over 90 million barrels of beer are aged every year in this nation. Vast quantities of malting barley, corn, rice, and hops are used. One of the branches of the ANTT is the permissive branch. This branch has to do with the administration of laws relating to the legitimate production of liquors, tobacco, cigarette papers, and tubes. The broad programs of the permissive branch are designed to protect the revenue derived from the legal alcohol and tobacco industries and protect the consumer and eliminate improper trade practices. All persons engaged in any legal liquor industry activity, except retailing, do so under permit or approved bond. To ensure protection of this revenue, government officers are stationed at plants to supervise the production, packaging, bottling, branding, and labeling of spirits. They also supervise the addition of spirits to wine at bonded wine cellars. The tax on beer is determined and paid by the brewer on the basis of a self-assessment system. To gain assurance of accurate and complete tax payment and of voluntary compliance with pertinent laws and regulations, ANTT inspectors examine brewery premises and operations. Distilled spirits plants, breweries, and wineries yield tax revenues of more than $3 billion a year. Truly big business. And it's the responsibility of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division to properly administer the federal law and to protect the revenue. Another sizable portion of the annual tax revenue comes from the tobacco industry. From these tobacco fields will come such manufactured items as chewing tobacco, smoking tobacco, and snuff, and other tobacco products such as cigars and cigarettes. The revenue from these products runs about $2 billion annually, but the federal laws relating to tobacco are enforced with comparatively little difficulty. It is in the area of illegal liquor production, or moonshining, that the ANTT enforcement branch finds its most difficult problems. Historically, rural areas of the nation have been the location in which most illicit distilling has taken place, and where the somewhat dubious methods of production have been handed down from generation to generation. In many such areas, public apathy to liquor law enforcement is traditional, and it is there that the ANTT division has experienced its greatest difficulties combating the moonshine liquor traffic, despite extensive seizures, arrests, and prosecutions. In recent years, in a few industrial areas, there has been a trend toward the syndicate type of illicit alcohol production on a relatively large scale. This is an actual distillery, seized in operation in an eastern state. Capturing the violators before they had an opportunity to unload their illegal product, the officers spike a carefully planned attempt to defraud the government of taxes. While very substantial inroads have already been made against the organized traffic in this area, the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division will not rest until it has completely eradicated it. Bootlegging, illegal and dangerous of itself, also tends to breed crimes of violence. Another vital function of the ANTT division is the enforcement of the National Firearms Act and the Federal Firearms Act. The principal objectives of these acts are to keep strictly gangster weapons, such as machine guns and sawed-off shotguns, out of the hands of criminals and to prohibit transporting, shipping, or receiving any type of firearm in interstate commerce. Here are some of the many weapons confiscated. Unless registered with the service, they are contraband, and their possession is a violation of the law. The ingenuity of the makers of illegal firearms is demonstrated here. A flare gun made into a firearm. An innocent-looking flashlight altered to fire a projectile. Even a cigarette lighter, adapted so as to be a lethal weapon. Most unusual of all are these cane guns. Falling into the any other weapon category, they obviously were designed with the element of concealment in mind. Possession of an unregistered firearm or any other violation of the National Firearms Act is punishable by a $2,000 fine or not more than 5 years imprisonment or both. Another important activity of the division is the Washington Headquarters Laboratory. Established under the Oleomargarine Act of 1886, the laboratory of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division was first concerned with butter, suspected of having been adulterated with oleomargarine. As the tax structure became more complex through the years, the laboratory's work was expanded to include examination of a wide variety of items in which alcohol or narcotics are components, or which otherwise require analysis for tax purposes. Today, the well-equipped Washington Headquarters Office and field laboratories examine each year over 38,000 samples of products, from brandy to bubble bath, from gunpowder to embalming fluid. It is the responsibility of the Alcohol and Tobacco Tax Division to administer and enforce the federal alcohol, tobacco, and firearms laws and regulations. And it is the duty of every citizen to cooperate wherever possible to help prevent fraud on the revenue.